What's up, Unique Nation? I'm back again with another video. And as you can see, we got my homegirl here with us today. Say hey. If you haven't already, go ahead, like, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Click that post notifications. And we're going to get straight to the video. You rock my world like outer space. Y'all some pictures. I had to put this clip in there so I can show y'all some pictures of after I had her, you know, just a little think about, yeah. My mind is like a river, and you always bathe in the water. Oh, I prayed for you. Oh, I cried for you. I can't believe we're here at last. Oh, I prayed for you. Oh, I cried for you. I can't believe we're here at last. Can you take me through? Touch me on my face. Kiss me on my hand. Okay, so we're gonna start off with how I went into labor. The night before I went into labor, I want to say it all happened because I was doing all this crazy ass shit. But people was giving me, like, they was giving me advice on how to put myself in labor or whatever. Or, you know, bring it. Stop. Yeah, so I was eating spicy food, bouncing on a ball, walking. All this crazy ass shit the day before I went into labor. I want to say like a few hours before I went into labor for real. Because I went into labor at 7 in the morning. I had started feeling like I didn't know they were contractions, but they were contractions the whole time. Because like every time I had bracing hits, I never actually felt them. Like I only knew because my stomach was hard as hell. I didn't feel my bracing hits most of the time that I always had them. Like I never felt them for real. And plus, I got like a high pain tolerance, so I guess that's why I didn't really feel them. But when I was having contractions, I didn't feel them at first. Like I didn't really know. Like they just felt like period cramps. So I was like, me and KP had just got to the apartment, whatever, and he had just got off work. It was 6. He usually get here like to my mama's house around 6, and then I just go to his apartment and just go stay with him. And it was 6 in the morning, and we were sitting here talking to my mama for a bit right before we had left or whatever. And once we had left, I don't know, but we was already there by 6:30, and we had laid down or whatever. And I didn't start feeling them until I actually laid down. They just started feeling like little period cramps.
Yeah, I had went in.
It was around 7 o'clock when I first started feeling my little cramps, and I was like, "Damn, they kind of hurt." But like, I didn't think much of it because I wasn't doing till the 20th. But I was like, I probably ain't even gonna go into labor until after. Like, I was saying like the 25th or something. I didn't really think much of it. I had crying at 10:30 in the morning that day. And I was like, damn. I hope I don't go into labor or whatever. But I was like, let me go ahead and start timing it. Because what if it is my contractions and I'm just not, I just don't know, you know. So, boom. I fall asleep for a couple minutes. I wake up around 6:25. Because I had heard, like, I turned in the bed and I felt this, like, pop. But I don't know if it to this day, I really don't know if it was my water that I heard break or what. But it was a loud, like, little noise. Like, it sounded like a bone had popped. But I know my bone didn't pop because, like, I popped my bone or something because I didn't feel my bone pop. But I felt it in my stomach, and it was like a hard little. I don't know, but my stomach was hard whenever I had tilted or whatever. So my stomach kept cramping or whatever. I was like, damn, I gotta get up. I'm gonna just go pee. I probably just had a pee or whatever. So I got up. As soon as I got up, my water had broke. Like, water just started dripping out my fucking pants. And I'm thinking I'm pissing on myself. So I was like, what the fuck? And KP already knocked out sleep. So I'm like, KP, and he won't get up. So I rushed to the restroom. And it's steady coming out. And I'm sitting on the toilet and it stopped. So I got up again and it's steady dripping. So I rushed to tell KP. I was like, KP, I think my water broke. And he was like, he looked at my pants. But, you know, my pants that I was wearing, they were like gray. Some weird texture. Kind of like this. So you couldn't really tell. And he was like, girl, that's not your water breaking. That's piss. Go lay down and clean it up. I was like, what the fuck? Like, bitch, my water broke and you over here saying crazy ass shit. So I was really mad. Yeah, this man talking about I pissed on myself. So I'm mad as fuck. So I was like, you know what? Fuck you. So I went back to the restroom. And I forgot. I had texted our friend. Her name is Zion. So I texted her and I was like, I told her. Because I was just talking to her that morning. Right before it happened or whatever. I think I want to say I was texting her. I can't remember. But yeah, I asked her. She was like, girl, that's your water. Go to the hospital. But you know, every time I was talking about when I go into labor, I'm going to go to Mobile for Gula. I don't really want to deliver in Gula. So boom, first thing I do. I called my mama and I told her, and she didn't really think my water had broke either. So I got up and I told KP again. I changed my pants like 3 times. And it stayed dripping. So I'm like, yeah, fuck that shit. That's my water. I'm not pissing on myself. So, but she being nosy. So he got up. He was like, all right, so we gonna go straight to the hospital, whatever, boom. And I'm thinking, I gotta get my baby stuff. I gotta get her bags. I gotta get everything. I gotta get my clothes. I didn't have all my clothes prepared yet. I had all her backpack but mine. So he was like, he was mad because I was talking about going to the house and get the stuff or whatever. But really, I ain't really just want to ride out there without my mom. Because, you know, I don't be knowing what the fuck to say when I go to the doctor's for real. So, soon as I made it to the hospital, whatever, they had put me in a wheelchair. They sent me straight back. And they tested to see if it was actually my water. But the lady was like, she already know it was my water, but she was just going to go ahead and do the little strip they put inside of you. So, she put the strip inside of me, and it turned blue. And she was like, yep, it's your water. So, I was already in the labor room. And she checked to see how far I was dilated. I was already 4 centimeters dilated. So I still wasn't really feeling my contractions, so whatever. They were like, are you okay? You sure you're not feeling anything? And you know, stuff like that. And I was like, no, I don't feel anything right now. And they were like, wow, you're handling it really well. And so yeah, by the time I made it to 6 centimeters, I couldn't handle that shit no more. And they gave me this medicine. Cause I was trying to hold out to the epidural, but I didn't want to hold out too late. And they don't be able to give it to me no more. Hold on, y'all. Let me go look at the group chat. I was already 4 centimeters dilated or whatever. So by the time I made it to 6 centimeters, I had asked them for some. I was like, go ahead, give me the epidural. Because I don't want to wait too late and I can't get it no more. Yeah, I was 6 centimeters dilated. And I asked them for the epidural, but the what they call the anesthesiologist wasn't there. He was like an hour away. I'm gonna say he was already at home. So I didn't really pay attention or whatever. And I was like, dang, they kept asking me if I wanted the epidural and they ain't hurrying up. What are they waiting on? Like, give me that shit right now, cause like it's gonna get a little painful. But I mean, it was bearable, but like, you know, I was already going crazy or whatever. So they had gave me this little medicine before they gave. They were like, do you want some medicine? We can give you some medicine. So they gave me the medicine and they started having me acting crazy and shit. Like, I was all woozy and shit. And I started seeing shit. So yeah, I was like, is this how the epidural gonna feel? If it is, I don't want it. Like, I felt like I was gonna die because, like, I was like, it's too much. I felt like it was gonna be too much medicine. I was like, I don't want it no more. Da, 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 this and that. But by the time the man got there, they put it in or whatever, and I started feeling well. Okay, so I'm gonna fast forward to by the time we started pushing or whatever. So y'all, by the time I started pushing was around 4:30, I want to say. I had her at 5:14 p.m. And it was already a while, you know, after already my water had broke. My water broke at 7:30 in the morning. It is 4:30 p.m. And that's already a while. My baby, you know, the fluid was without fluid or whatever. But when my baby was born, she was born with fluid in her lungs still. So soon as she came out, she looked purple. Like, she looked purple when she was first born. But I wasn't really paying attention to that. I was paying attention to why my baby not crying. And, you know, usually whenever you have your baby, they throw your baby right to you or whatever. Like, you know, you be having to catch the motherfucker. So they didn't do that with me. So I was holding my hands out, you know, trying to get my baby. And they didn't give her to me. So I seen that they had to go ahead and talk, pass it to the other nurse or whatever. And they were trying to get my baby to breathe because she wasn't actually crying. So they trying to get a cry out of her and she still wasn't crying, but they started doing all type of shit, trying to get fluid out her lungs and stuff like that. And she started crying a little bit, but it took her a minute for real. Like, I want to say like three minutes. Like, she was breathing, it's just that she wasn't crying, you know, like a baby supposed to cry when they born. So yeah, I was like, what's wrong? Why she not crying? You know, like, all type of shit or whatever. So, yeah. Since my baby was born with them fluids in her lungs, was because, you know, my water had already broke. Since it was already broke for a long time, you know, like, it was hours already. So yeah, my baby, the fluid had got into her lungs or whatever, and they had to get all of that out. And after that, soon as they got her to cry a little bit, my baby was white as hell, like whiter than me, like white as fuck. And I don't know, she was just really, really pale. And I was like, oh my gosh, she's so white, whatever. They were like, we're only gonna give her to you for at least 5 minutes, and we're gonna have to go to the run her to the back and run her some tests, make sure everything's fine. So I didn't get my baby back till like 6 hours later, cause had her at 5. I didn't get her till like around 11. It wasn't 6. I want to say like 5. I don't know. No, like 5 or 6. I didn't get her till like 12 or 11 p.m. I don't remember. I want to say it was 11 p.m. And, yeah. By the time they brought her back, they were saying that her test had read good. But it had to keep running all type of lab work on her, blood work, all of that. So, yeah. I was doing well. At first, I was doing well. I didn't have no problem with seeing River because they were actually treating me right. But, well, I felt like they were treating me right. They were, you know, they were running all type of work on my baby. Like, we couldn't get dismissed. I mean, so I had her Sunday at 5:14 p.m., January 16th. I did not get discharged until Wednesday. So, no. I didn't get discharged until Tuesday night. It was around 8:30 p.m. Really, like, almost 9. We had to wait till her blood culture came back and make sure that it was good to go or whatever, and that she passed everything. Which she did. Only thing was that she didn't pass her hearing test, that whenever they had took that hearing test for her, she didn't pass it on one side. But we already got that out the way, and she passed her hearing test on both sides. So yeah, they had discharges that night, but the day that they discharged us, y'all, the nursery had came to discharge her. The day that we was getting discharged, though, they had brought me some papers. My nurse had brought my papers to me, like, around, I want to say, like, 10 in the morning, 11 in the morning. And she didn't really run through nothing. Like, she didn't say shit. Like, she didn't actually tell me that I was being discharged or nothing. She didn't say nothing to me. She was like, we're going to have a busy day, so I'm going to leave your papers right here, and I'm going to come back later. So, I was waiting for her to come back, but she never actually came back. So, like I said, it was around 8:30, almost 9. Around that time when we got discharged and her nursery had came, you know, I had to make sure that she gave me all her information about Legacy and, you know, her work, her blood work, all of that. Her test that made sure that they were all okay and she was good to go, which thankfully it was. But y'all know how after having a baby, you're supposed to get on a wheelchair and just in case anything happens, because, you know, you just had a baby or whatever. They did not do that. They did not. They let me walk all the way downstairs without a wheelchair. My nurse never actually really discharged me or told me any information about my postpartum stuff. Like, you know, they didn't actually tell me anything about me. Like, you know, no sex for 6 weeks. You can't do this and that for 6 weeks. You know, all that type of shit. They didn't tell me none of that. They only had, only her nursery had came whenever we were being discharged. And yeah, so, boom. Soon as we made it, I started having a headache, but it was just like a bearable headache. So I was like, you know what? It's probably just because I'm walking or whatever, all this walking. So I kept telling my mama I kept having a headache. And the next morning, it was still bad. So my headache had gotten way too bad. Like, they were saying all type of shit, because when I had my baby, my fever was high as fuck. So it caused her to have a high fever as well. She had a fever too, because since I had a fever, it gave her a fever. So that's another reason why they had to keep her a bit longer too. Well, you know, keep taking her back. But yeah, as soon as I kept having that badass headache and it never went away. My mom had brought me some medicine when she got off work that morning. And she had brought me some Tylenol or something like that. And it went away with that one. But whenever I went to sleep again, I woke up and my headache was back again. I took some more medicine. That shit did not work anymore. Like, I was like, what the fuck? Like, it never actually worked. So my mama had to go back to work around 4 o'clock, 4:30. And so she had left back. So yeah, my stepdaddy had brought me some more pills. And the pills that he brought me, it was like Excedrin, you know, the migraine pills or whatever. And that didn't work for me either. So I was like, what the fuck? Like, none of this medicine is actually working for me. So I was confused. Like, why the fuck is this medicine? Why is it not working for me? So, yeah, I was doing fine that night. Like, you know, being able to move around and shit. So I was like, you know what? I'm finna leave work. It was around 8 something. She was like, I'm finna leave work. I'm finna come take you to the hospital, because it's not good that you still having this headache. Like, it's not normal. So when she got here, it wasn't even a full day that I was discharged and I was back at the fucking hospital. So it took, you know, Gula take fucking hours and shit. So I was from there from, I want to say like 9, no, like 8 something. And when we made it to the hospital, and my headache was still bad. It was 8 something, my blood pressure was high, and that's the reason why she really wanted to take me, because my blood pressure was high. And she was like, your blood pressure high, plus you got the headache, and it's not normal. So she went ahead and took me to the hospital. And, you know, we was there from, I want to say 9 something all the way till, I don't remember what time it was. It was like 3 in the morning till they actually put me to the bank. And it was like 3 in the morning. And they was running some work on me or whatever. And they got to saying some crazy ass shit about 6 in the morning. Like, whenever all that stuff came back, they were trying to say that I had tumor. some all type of shit in my head. So I was like, what the fuck? Like, I just had a baby and I'm learning, like, you know, I'm being told that I got a fucking tumor in my head and shit. Emotional and shit. So I bust out crying, like, damn, I got a fucking tumor in my head. They ran all type of work, so it wasn't preeclampsia after birth. I didn't even know you could have that. After having the baby, you could still catch preeclampsia. But it wasn't that either. So I knew that I had high blood pressure at that point. But they were like, we're going to keep you and this and that. So I'm thinking I'm only going to stay for one day or whatever. So I was there from Tuesday night again from 9 all the way to Saturday morning. And I wasn't able to move. I wasn't able to feed myself, feed my baby right, change her, none of that. They had me on some meds for my blood pressure to keep me on regulate my blood pressure back up or whatever, so that I wouldn't have to need some meds after I had left. And yeah, and the nurse that had came in was a lady who was who helped me deliver my baby. And y'all, let me tell y'all how my OB wasn't even the one who delivered my baby. It was the on-call doctor. And I was shook because I could have sworn that your OB is the one, you know, they call them and they deliver your baby still, but it didn't work out like that. Kept running me on some medicine for my blood pressure. And, you know, still had the headaches, but they was giving me some medicine for it. And I had started to feel back well. But Friday night, they had got me off the blood pressure medicine. I'm feeling a bit better, but then my headache eventually came back, like around an hour or two after being off of it. So then they were like, okay, so it's not your blood pressure, whatever. We don't know where the headache is coming from for real. So we don't really know what's causing your headache. So at that point, it wasn't my blood pressure no more, because my blood pressure was already doing well. They kept checking my own vitals or whatever. And yeah, so I still don't know what happened with the headache. Like, I was having a terrible ass headache for days. And yeah, so they gave me some stronger medicine for specifically that. And when they gave me that, it eventually went away. Like, it went away completely. But like the second night of being there, the second time after being admitted, y'all, they was trying to get me up out of there. She was like, well, you need to get to eating so we can go ahead and get you out of here. If you're feeling better, this and that. But I wasn't feeling well still. Like, my headache was still hurting. So I went ahead and ordered some food because she kept bugging. So I went to order some food. I couldn't even eat though because I kept vomiting. Couldn't get up. Couldn't feed my baby. Couldn't feed myself. Go to use the restroom by myself. None of that. Like, my body was weak as fuck. By the time Saturday came in the morning, my headache went away after they gave me that other medicine that morning. I was discharged finally Saturday. And the next day, my baby had already made a week. That shit flew by so fast. I didn't even realize how many days I was there. I could barely see. My left eye, everything was blurry. You know, I couldn't fully function by myself, right? So I do not recommend y'all to go have y'all baby at Singing River. Go to Mobile if y'all having a baby. That's what I was planning to do. It's just that I didn't really think my water had actually broke. And I was thinking my OB was going to actually deliver my baby or whatever. But we should have just took our ass to Mobile that day. And the second time when they admitted me. Because they was just saying all type of shit. Didn't even know what was going on with me and none of that. From the help that I was receiving from Mom and KP, that shit, like, if I wouldn't have had that help, I don't think I would have been able to do that shit right for real. Like, by myself. Because if I would have never said nothing, because I have a high pain tolerance. If I would have never said nothing, I don't know how I would be right now. Like, imagine if I would just suck that shit up and something really wrong with me, you know. because I'm not the type of person just like going to the hospital or just like getting medicine, taking medicine, anything like that. But my baby will be 3 weeks tomorrow. Tomorrow is February the 6th. And guys, I will let y'all, I'll talk to y'all in my next video. Go ahead, like, subscribe to our YouTube channel, hit that post notification, and let me know in the comment section what type of videos y'all would like to watch of me and Legacy. And yeah, I'm gonna go show y'all my baby before we end the video. Say bye, Unique Nation. We'll see you in the next video. Say bye bye. Hold on. Y'all, my daughter looks just like her fucking dad. Poor baby. Say bye, y'all. Say bye bye. Okay, y'all. We'll see y'all in the next video. Stay tuned. Hit that post notification. Like this video. And comment down in the comment section what y'all would like to see next. And we'll see you guys next time. We'll see you guys next time. Bye.